When you're taking the SAT and get stuck on a math problem, you might feel your confidence sink. But luckily, there's a quick, effective way to get it swimming again. Welcome back to SAT for Free. Hi, everyone, and welcome to Lesson 5 of SAT for Free. I'm Jesse Novotny, and I'm the Educational Advisor here at Student Tutor. It's my job to talk to parents and students and answer any questions they have about the SAT. So why am I here? Well, to talk about estimating. Estimating? What? Isn't that the same thing as guessing, right? Well, no. And I'll tell you why in just a few seconds. But first, if you haven't enrolled in our free 5-week SAT program yet, make sure to do so by clicking here. Also, if you have not read the reading assignment on the estimating strategy, make sure to do that before you watch the video by clicking here. Okay, let's get started. So, first and foremost, the most important piece of knowledge to take away from this lesson is that unless otherwise stated, all SAT diagrams are drawn to scale. So, what does that mean? On the SAT, math problems often get a little illustration on the side called figures or diagrams, and the problems can involve the figures. For instance, there can be a drawing of a gray cube with a small white square in the middle, and the problem might ask you to figure out the size of the white square. And you can always figure out problems like this algebraically. You know, with formulas and fancy math facts and everything. This is doable. But if you're stuck, you can also just look at the picture, look at the answer options, and kind of, sort of, figure out what might fit best. And why can you do this? Because the diagrams on the SAT are drawn to scale. So if the white square looks like it's about half the size of the gray square, it is about half the size of the gray square. The only time you can't use this strategy is as if the diagram specifically says not drawn to scale. But that's pretty easy to remember, right? Also, what do you do if there isn't a diagram? Or if there is one, but it isn't labeled? Simple. You just use the description to draw one yourself. Let's try an example of drawing your own diagram. So let's try this one. All faces of a cube with a 4-meter edge are covered with striped paper. If the cube is then cut into cubes with 1-meter edges, how many of the 1-meter cubes have striped paper on exactly one face? Ugh, seems a little complicated, but let's break it down. All the instructions are right there in the problem. First, we've got a cube. So that's a 6-sided square, right? All sides are equal. And it says here the edge is 4 meters. So automatically, all the sides are 4 meters. Now, we're going to imagine that we're wrapping the outside in striped paper. I'm not going to draw the stripes because that'll just get confusing really fast. But just imagine with me. So the outside is covered in stripes, striped paper. And next, the problem wants us to cut the cube into a bunch of 1-meter cubes. So that'll look something like this. And according to the problem, we want to figure out how many of these little itty-bitty cubes have striped paper on exactly one side. But if you're looking at this side, only these 4 cubes in the middle fit that description, right? All these other cubes have paper on at least 2 sides. So now we know that 4 cubes in the middle of each face fit the description, and there are 6 faces. So 4 times 6 is 24. See? Easy. Now that we did a drawing your own diagram example, let's try a quick one with estimating the answer from an already existing diagram. So with this diagram, you know that it's a square because, well, it says it's a square. And so you know the area of the whole thing is 4 times 4, so 16. Now you need to find the area of this blue triangle. It looks like it's a little less than half, right? So first, before we do anything, let's cross off options that don't make any sense. 10 is more than half, 9 is more than half, 8 is exactly half, and this is a little less, so all of those get crossed off too. That leaves us 4 and 6. And 4 would be exactly 1/4 of the square. And this looks a little bigger than that. So we know the answer is 6. Obviously, since I'm explaining this as we go along, it's taking a lot longer than it would if you were just doing it on your own on the test. And of course, you could solve this using the Pythagorean theorem. But if you happen to blank on that, estimating is what will save you. So make sure you pay attention to the diagrams. If you're strapped for time and stuck on a problem, they can provide the key you need to get the right answer and keep moving. Don't underestimate the estimating strategy. So, for all our SAT for free students, remember that your homework is due Wednesday. For everyone else, if you'd like to get in on the action, click the link in the description and sign up for our class. It's 5 weeks long and includes the 10 lessons that are absolutely free. Finally, click here if you see the importance of the SAT exam and want more. We have customized programs, private tutoring, and a self-study course, all guaranteed to increase your score. Happy learning!